It's such an honor that so many people across party lines have expressed their support.
In what has become a contentious election season, candidates scramble for last-minute support wherever they can find it. Delaware Senate candidate Christine O'Donnell, a conservative Tea Party favorite, now turns to an unlikely group for votes, Democrats.
What I think is the most telling about the coalition Democrat for O'Donnell's is it expresses a frustration with both political parties.
O'Donnell is outspoken on a number of conservative policies, including the extension of the Bush tax cuts, abolishing the inheritance tax, and stopping cap-and-trade energy legislation.
So what this administration is proposing are the largest tax increases in U.S. history. They're coming this January. We cannot afford this.
O'Donnell's conservative stance on fundamental issues doesn't stop registered Democrat voters like John Thompson of Newark, Delaware, from throwing their support behind the Republican candidate.
So those of us are concerned about the, you know, expansion of government, the likelihood of increased taxes, cap and trade, those kind of issues, who, you know, those of us who are against those things are, you know, supporting Christine.
Democrats for O'Donnell represents a national trend of voters who have in the past considered themselves Democrats or fallen somewhere in between the two parties and are now leaning toward the right.
The issues that are being pushed by the Democratic Party do not fall in line with my personal beliefs.
So, President Obama, did you vote for him?
No. And actually, I voted for him in the primary. That was more a vote against Hillary than a vote for him.
It is people like Thompson, people who have voted for Democrats in the past but are planning to vote Republican on Tuesday, that will determine the outcome of this election. These voters are what have Democrats concerned in the last days of the national race for the Senate, whether or not it's enough to earn one woman from Delaware a seat in Washington. Chandler Clay, American Observer.